Everyone, welcome round two. We have won the roll, so we are going to play first, of course. This hand looked pretty good when it had a line of rolls in it, but the other six are a little suspect, so I am somewhat skeptical about its playability. So I think I'm going to mold in this one. On the other hand, I do have a lot of spells in my deck left over, so if I draw well, then that ends up being okay. But I think I'm going to try another one. This hand, probably going to have to mulligan this one also. So, but I'll keep this. Sylvan Library is pretty sick, so I'll get back in the game right quickly. Who knows, I may even draw Raphaelis on turn two. That is a pretty brutal double mulligan. If I had one more spell in that first hand, I'd probably keep literally any spell. Unfortunately, it was just a little bit too unruly to keep otherwise. Ugh. Don't really like seeing Mountain when I have Sylvan Library in my hand, but you know. What are you going to do? So we're going to go ahead and lead off with this and hopefully draw into something sweet. If not, then it'll be a quick game and on to game two. But for the most part, I do not anticipate drawing too many cards with this. Maybe not. That was not a two drop. Let's go ahead and auto yield. Bam. You want to use the ability? Yeah, I kind of do. Uh-huh. Well, kind of want to pay for life just to see an action spell next turn, because I want to be able to cast something on turn four, and this is going to probably kill something on turn five. So we're going to go ahead and put those two cards back. Pay for life for this one. Put this one back. Play Forest because we may hit Leatherback Baloth and pass a turn. It's unfortunate that I can't play an island, but okay, and he's on mono nothing, so we're going to use the ability again. And Sphere, right on time. So we're going to go ahead and put this back, and this back, and put them both back. And now we can go ahead and play this and pretend we have a counterspell up. So we're going to go ahead and do it like that. Who knows? We may even draw something sweet. Huh. Well, that's interesting. So, all right, use this again. Troll Ascetic. Well, let's see. We can slime his Prismatic Lens. I mean, he didn't do anything on 5 mana, so that means that he's probably not going to do anything on 6, or on next turn. So I think we can probably keep, or do I want to pay another one? That's fine. So we'll keep, one. And let's go ahead and slime this guy. Slime this guy back into the last turn. Getting rid of that. I don't know what kind of hand this guy kept. Maybe he saw he was mulliganing and felt that he could keep a pretty loose one on the draw. I mean, I've done that before, plenty of times. You guys have seen me do it. So this guy is probably thinking, what do I do now? Well, it's probably gonna be play a land and do nothing, because that's what you did last turn. So I'm gonna go ahead and, I can't really necro too many more turns. Because I have to respect the fact that he's got mountains. And we did pass a devil's play, so I don't want to go down to 8 and just have him burn me for 5, burn me for 3. That would be quite embarrassing. And we're off to the races. Jeez, one more land, we can draw Woodfall Prime, or summon Woodfall Primus. Would we like to use the ability? Yep. Old Man of the Sea. Well, that's interesting, because we can play Troll Ascetic also. And then if he has something like Rolling Earthquake, then we just get owned. So I don't really know how much I want to do that. Kind of just want to play, Old Man of the Sea seems like he's not going to be that great. Do you want to pay 4 life? No, I don't think so. Not this time. So let's get our beatdown plan on. I wonder if he has Yeva. At the same time, I just want to play both. And if he's got something, then good for him. Hopefully he doesn't, because that would suck. I really don't want to get Earthquaked. And Rolling Earthquake. Okay. Lovely. You gonna use the ability? Yeah. Awesome. Don't really want to pay more life. Go down to 5 against Devil's Play. Yeah, why did I have a feeling? This guy's probably gonna cast something for a lot of mana. Wyrmcoil engine. Sure, you have a Wyrmcoil engine. What do I have? I have a land on top. It's an island. What's below that island? Another island. Caramba. Well, I guess we just have to play a land, hope he doesn't kill us. This was a bit of an embarrassing game. I thought we were going to be okay with the Sylvan. Oh man, he's got the Wasteland. But apparently we weren't. Would Troll Ascetic have been good here? Probably. I'm just going to get like Devils played out by this do nothing midrange deck. He's going to play Yveh Etten a turn, so he has to play two things. Right? Wall of Blossoms. All right. Time to get something started. And now, do we have Devil's Play? I feel like it's going to be pretty difficult to win this game. So we have to control magic something, so here's hoping. Impulse. Jeez, that was insane. All right, so we're going to go ahead and Impulse now because, yeah, we might as well. Awakening Zone and Opposition. You know, those are pretty good, but they're not really going to do it for us. So let's go ahead and move on to game two. So we've got Rolling Earthquake, three colors. Let's go ahead and check some stuff out. So what can we bring in? We're going to Fathom Seer. Fathom Seer is probably going to be better than some do-nothing creature that doesn't do anything. We have Leatherback Baloth, so we can move that in. Leatherback Baloth does bring the beats, though, and it is pretty hard to Earthquake away. So we could keep that in. Yeah, I mean, this is fine. We'll just try this. And, you know, actually keep a hand that's. Man, if we kept that hand in game one, that would've been sick. No, actually it wouldn't have been. We'll just, you know, actually draw reasonably.